Hey guys, Spiritual Whistleblower here on this very rainy October. What's today's date? Today is the 5th. We're in the first week of October. It is Domestic Violence Awareness Month. It is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and I do believe Sickle Cell Anemia Awareness Month. But yes, I just want to take this time out very quickly to thank everyone who came out. I did my summer tour. It was a complete success from beginning to end. I went to all the cities as I promised, showed up, and it was successful. And I closed out at Houston, Texas, and it was just beautiful. I want to thank everyone that came out. Some of y'all have been with me for a couple of years. You've been to previous seminars that I've had in the past. Thank you for being a loyal supporter. Thank you to the new people that a lot of women who came out just discovered me, like literally a week or two ago. Like they just found me on TikTok or something and they came out. Thank you as well. It all means a lot to me. So I think next summer I will not do the seminars. I need to take a break and focus on greater things ahead. I really enjoyed doing seminars and meeting. I met so many amazing people. You take the good with the bad. I've met a lot of not so nice people as well that pretended to be empaths just to meet me in person and get close to me. So, you always have to take the good with the bad, but I wouldn't change a thing because I have met some, when I tell you I have met some truly amazing people along the way, I wouldn't change a thing. But I have to get to the next level, you guys. I have to. I've given y'all 3 consistent years of these seminars, and I just need to take a break to get to the next level and to work on me and focus on my self-care and other goals that I have. But I will continue to put out content. I will continue to put out more books, So the demand is there and there's a need for it. And I just love you guys. Now, with that out the way, I want to talk about, I don't think I've seen anything on this, but the narcissists, why they get involved with you, aside from the other stuff that we all know, they targeted you for money, your good looks, your status, that's the surface level type of stuff. But I want to share something else that the reason why they targeted you, whether it's a friendship, whether it's a relationship, the narcissist needs a story to tell. The narcissist needs a story to tell. I might have talked about this briefly a very long time ago in one of my videos. I think I made a video a couple years ago briefly talking about this, but I'm gonna go into depth about it. The narcissist needs a story to tell. You know how reality TV, if you guys are familiar with Love and Hip Hop, shoot, any of the reality TV shows that have a storyline, there's a cast, a whole cast and crew in this reality TV show. And every cast member has a specific storyline. And most of these people on these reality TV shows are narcissistic. Just study their personalities. Watch how they cheat on each other. They're fighting. They backstab. They like drama. Narcissists love drama. And I can understand why they're on these reality TV shows because drama means high ratings. So, of course, the producers are going to cast people with toxic personalities into these roles on reality TV because it's guaranteed drama. The narcissist is going to guarantee, I mean, they're going to bring the drama. They're going to bring the fights. They're going to bring the backstabbing, manipulative behavior. And that's what drives the ratings up. Well, each and every one of those reality TV stars, they all each have their own storyline. If you pay attention, everybody has a storyline. And depending on how toxic and dramatic that storyline is, that's going to extend their longevity on the TV show. And if they continue to stay on the TV show, They get pay raises. Their money bag increases. So the more creative they have to become with inventing their fucking storyline to maintain their longevity on the show to increase their paychecks. Are y'all following me? So take that same theory and apply it to your life and all the toxic people you've encountered, all the narcissists that you've encountered, friendships, lovers, etc., family, and really think about it. Reflect back on all those situations and let me ask you something. Because I know the answer to this already, but I just want you to think about it for a minute. All those people that you have gotten rid of, that had double-crossed you, backstabbed you, your ex cheated on you, your mama spread gossip to the rest of the family about you, your friend backstabbed you and is sleeping with all your ex-boyfriends. Like, look at all these people that you have gotten rid of out of your life. And what do they have in common? I guarantee you, number one, they don't have nothing of substance going on in their lives. Okay? They have boring fucking lives. Number two, the people that they involve themselves with, their circle of friends, their clique, their family and all that, they're a bunch of fucking nobodies too. And number three, now that you've removed yourself from their lives, they look fucking pathetic. They don't like, they was popping when they was around you because your shine, everything awesome about you was rubbing off on them. Now that you cut them the fuck off, they just look lackluster. They're not glowing or shining anymore. They look fucking pathetic. So what they will do, because they know they've disrespected you, they know they've done some shady shit to you, they know they've gossiped about you, they know what they did to you, they know they didn't treat you right. It was all calculated. So once you cut them off and you move on and you begin the process of leveling up and getting your life back on track, they're going to go around. And this is not the smear campaign. We talk about the smear campaign all the time. We're all familiar with it. This is similar to the smear campaign. And, you know, it kind of is parallel to it. The narcissist needs a story to tell. Because the narcissist has no fucking life, no fucking identity, no nothing. You are the narcissist's storyline. So they're going to sit up, besides smearing you and tearing you down, anything good that you got going on in your life, they're going to connect their name to it. I guarantee you, if you bounce back, when you bounce back, not if, because you are going to bounce back, when you bounce back, when you begin to level up again, when great things start happening as a result of you cutting that toxic person off, they're watching you. They're watching everything, honey. Them fake accounts are spying. They got people watching you. They are watching you. You understand me? When good shit starts happening to you again, they're going to want to associate their name to yours. Well, you know, I used to hang out with her and, you know, yeah, I'm the reason that she's leveling up. And I'm the reason, you know, I told her, I gave her the advice to do what she's doing now. They got to connect their motherfucking name, not just for the bad shit, but for the good shit too. And the crazy shit is they didn't contribute a motherfucking thing to your success. The only positive thing they have contributed is disappearing. Disappearing. Yeah, you did me a favor when you disappeared from my life. You did me a favor when you backstabbed me. You did me a favor when you talked shit and tried to turn my friends against me. You did me a favor when you talked about me like a dog to my family members. You did me a huge favor when you showed me who you are. I saw your real character. That's the only motherfucking favor you did me. Because everything else over here, the success and all the accolades and the shit that I'm getting, the blessings as a result of cutting you off, that's straight from God. You can't put claims on stuff that came from God, but the narcissist will. That narcissist needs a story to tell because he has no motherfucking identity, number one. and he has no life. You are the life. You are the storyline. You are everything. Well, you know, I used to hang with the spiritual whistleblower, and I know firsthand where she buys her shoes, and I know firsthand who does her hair, and I know firsthand where she went to college, and I was with her when we went here, and I was with her. Now all of a sudden they got a motherfucking story to tell since you cut their asses the fuck off. See, with me, you know, I don't do that. When I'm done with somebody, I don't want nobody to know I even fucking dealt with you. I don't want nobody to know I hung out with you. I'm not going to mention your fucking name. You are nothing to me. You are absolutely fucking nothing to me. You are in the past. You are dead. You are deceased. You're nothing to me. So I don't need no motherfucking storyline, because I have an identity and I have a life. I have a life that was there before I fucking met you. I have a motherfucking life. I'm being blessed left and right. I don't have to associate my name to you or anyone else from my past to shine. But see, toxic is toxic. Toxic people have no self-worth. Toxic people have they are very insecure. They're very weak. So they have to attach. They have attachment issues. Even when you move the fuck on and you don't want nothing to do with them, they still got your name in their motherfucking mouth. They still trying to attach themselves to you. Well, you know the reason why she's doing good is because I told her, you know, I gave her good advice when we used to be cool, and she's, you know, she stole everything from me. They cannot fucking detach for shit. These are very codependent, very toxic codependent people we're talking about with attachment issues. See, you have no problem detaching from them and treating them like they're dead. Like, why would I bring your name up? Because your name holds no clout. Your name holds no weight. The narcissist's name holds no clout, no weight, no power. So why would you bring it up? It's not going to get you into new doors. Mentioning the narcissist is not going to bring you no new opportunities. No, no, no. But when they mention your name, they know that people are going to be interested, because you are a fucking somebody. You are lit. That's why they targeted you to begin with. They needed a story to tell, because they don't have shit else going on in their fucking lives. Move on, and I guarantee you, 5, 10, 12 years from now, they still going to be talking about everything you're doing. Not just the bad shit. Because, of course, you know they're going to play victim, and it's going to be, woe is me. Oh, Chanel did me so dirty, and Chanel this. But they got all the good shit that you're about to get, all them blessings that are coming, they're going to attach their name to that too. Well, you know the only reason she getting the good shit is because, you know, I helped her get all of that. I gave her advice on how to get to where she's getting. It's me. They're going to want to take credit for shit that you done moved the fuck on, and they still trying to involve and insert themselves in your life and take credit and claims for shit that ain't got nothing to do with them. They need a story to tell. Because without you in their lives, they're empty. They have nothing of substance. They have no identity. They have nothing. So I hope that opens up some sort of, you know, let's talk about it in the comment section. Okay, guys, tell me if all the people you've cut off in your past are still trying to attach their names to yours, even when you're doing good things with your life. I promise you they will. And on that note, Spiritual Whistleblower here, y'all have a blessed day.